Hello, dear viewer. So my channel has been devoid of RAR for the last few months or so, but there's still some of you who would like to see more installments. For some odd reason or another. So in those rare moments when it occurs to me to do another RAR, this will be the place where you can find them. So today I decided to look into my mailbag for viewer suggestions on who I might RAR next. And I'm finding that these suggestions are getting a little samey. Do Darkside Phil. Do Movie Bob. Do JonTron. Hell, my own friend Helsing920 keeps asking me to rip on him for X or Y reason. You know what? I need something completely under the radar. Something totally out of the mainstream of YouTube consciousness. Then I got into a fevered conversation with my buddy Protorock on Skype, and learned of a guy who paid to put his ads all over YouTube for a quick jumpstart to fame, a man by the name of Andre Meon, currently sitting on 683 subs with a YouTube name Meon Walker. No guesses as to what that might be a reference to, huh? Now we're talking. All right, let's take a look at his channel intro. Okay, homemade sound effects and special effects, huh? Ooh, let's see if we can replicate those. Ba-ding!
Greetings, programs.
Greetings, programs?
I'm a Brazilian comedian and host of Meon Walker. There's gonna be reviews, vlogs, let's plays, and good old-fashioned stand-up comedy.
Yep, his channel contains all of that, as well as this clip he humorously calls a bonus clip.
Warning, popular but shitty Nickelback song is about to be massacred by a YouTuber.
Bonus.
Don't worry, take your time, Meon. Take all the time you need to shower us with your awesome, golden, dulcet tones of your voice.
I am so high, I can hear heaven. I'm so high, I can hear heaven. Over heaven, no heaven, don't hear me. And they say that a hero could save us. I'm not gonna stand here and wait. I hold on to the wings of the heroes. Watch as we all fly away.
What was that you sang?
I'm so high.
I'm finding it difficult to tell you where it all went wrong, because it all went wrong. The dancing, the inappropriate song, everything. Louis, yes or no?
No.
Cheryl?
No.
I don't know the rest of the lyrics.
And that would be a no from me, too. Okay, so you can't sing, but can you review? Let's take a look. Alright, so we're going to take a quick look at his very first review, an episode he called Wetarded. Off to a wonderful start there with 1,339 views in 1 year, and the rating definitely suggests that people were put off by clicking on your ad. Alright, Meon, wow me. Meon Walker, as exciting as filming a corner of your room in slow motion? Yes, kids, it's the Meon Walker Show, now in
Potato Vision.
What about this theme song? What are they singing exactly? Is it an homage to Pokemon? I mean, just listen.
Columbia, Columbia, Columbia. Columbia, Columbia, Columbia.
Greetings, programs.
If I were your program, I'd be shutting myself down automatically by now.
Welcome. In case you were wondering, the name of the show is pronounced Mion Walker. I don't know why I did that.
Yeah, I don't know why you called yourself Mion Walker either when your name is Andre.
First, I want to say hi to my friends on Facebook and my followers on Twitter. And I don't know if you've seen my stand-up on YouTube, which I promise will have English subtitles one day.
Oh, I looked for your stand-up, but all I can seem to find is your karaoke and Let's Plays. Must not be all that great, I'm guessing, or you would have uploaded it by now.
But in case you don't know who I am, I'm Brazilian. I'm a comedian. Yeah, right. I'm Brazilian. I'm comedian. Hi, how are you? No, I'm a comedian from Brazil. And what's this show about? Well, it's about me.
Yikes, you're Brazilian, and the show is all about you. Ooh, I'd better get settled in. This is going to be one long... How long is this video anyway? Oh my god. 48 minutes? What the hell is wrong with you, Mion? So far, your seeming lack of charisma, your boring voice, and above all, your crappy singing have demonstrated to me that you cannot hold anyone's attention for nearly that long. Oh, God. Well, unlike you, I'm going to summarize your video.
And it's about the week.
Great.
But before you turn this off...
I was thinking of doing that.
Let me just tell you a little bit about the process here.
The process? What process?
Because this is a first episode, but it's... more like an introduction
to what? To that
statement,
Leonard Nimoy poster?
Kind of thing. And as you can see, I'm here on my Tron set with matching Tron suit.
Nothing there looks like Tron.
Myself. And as you can see, they glow on camera
and as
too,
you can see, you're a dork, yes.
Which I think is it's an old trick I stole from Superman.
What? Superman? What?
The movie. It's a little trick I stole from... Donner
That's
Superman.
The third time you said stole.
And
you have a thing about stealing, don't you?
I've been wanting to do this for a while.
Everybody wants to be a YouTube star.
If you're a content producer on the internet, you know how hard this is.
It's not hard at all.
Man, I've had to deal with...
What? Not having a job?
Construction noise.
Ooh.
Can't film when there's construction. Don't believe me, I have footage.
You know, this is easily remedied. Just film in a place with less noise.
I had to... get a new camera because...
Alright, seriously, dude, are you just going to ramble on? Is this your video? 40 minutes of this? Let's fast forward to the actual we view, shall we?
Had to get new lights, and I'm kind of a perfectionist, so I'll do a bunch of these and you'll only see the best one. Just like a real comedian.
That was the best one, huh? That was the best take, the one with all those pauses in it, huh? Let me try. I'm a great comedian, I will only give you the bunch of the... I will give you the best of the bunch, the bestos asbestos we can. Haha, asbestos. Hello, I will best you best. Let's do that again. Cha. Buncho, cruncho, buncha crunch. Besto, cruncho, buncha, wencha, buncher. I will do the... I will only give you the bunch of the best. The best of the bunch of the bunch of the best. Hi. I am comedian. Only give you the best possible take of the bunch, because... Yeah, let's just go with that one.
So he has this toilet paper, which I use to wipe... I've been wanting to do this show. To my knowledge, there's no show about the Wii on the internet. There must be, but I watch a lot of shows, and to my knowledge, there isn't one.
Dude, I hate to burst your live the last 7 years of your life in a cave bubble, but there are tons upon thousands of Wii-related shows, videos, reviews, the Wii Viewer, etc. that exist on YouTube. Your idea is about as fresh and new as Nostradamus' corpse.
And this is all I ever wanted to do as a comedian, was talk about video games and superheroes and sci-fi movies. You can't do that in a bar.
Actually, yes you can. I did it just last night with one of my best friends. Well, we did it at a hookah lounge, not at a bar, but it's the same thing. A hookah lounge is basically just a bar for smokers as opposed to for alcoholics. But, yeah, you want to do this for a living, I guess, on YouTube? Get in line, and let me tell you, the success rate sucks. Judging by the fact that you're already in the red from paying for ads to get plugged on YouTube, and the fact that you're still getting anywhere from 300 to 400 views per video, you're making, what, 10 cents to a dollar per video so far? Yeah. Word to the wise, don't quit your day job just yet.
You know, I've done the Seinfeld thing. I've been there. If you've seen my stand-up, you know, I've done that, but I had to dumb my material down to a nightclub audience. I had to do the, hey, did you ever notice thing? By the way, Seinfeld said he would never join Facebook or Twitter, but now he has.
Alright, so for the next 5 minutes or so, he talks about Seinfeld for some odd reason, and then he starts yammering on about his own stand-up experience, which is notably missing from his channel, so don't believe a word of it. Let's fast forward the next 20 minutes or so of unnecessary rambling to get to your actual jokes and commentary about the Wii. You've taken way too much of my time rambling, and you haven't even gotten to that point yet, and we're already like 15 minutes in, and I'm starting to doze off, and I'm curious just how intellectual, insightful, and funny your video game-related humor actually is. Considering this is the material you apparently had to dumb down for your in-real-life audience. Ooh, I'm waiting with bated breath. Whoa, back up. Did I see Bill Hicks used in your video?
I feel like a fucking brony, you know? Like, no one cares about this thing that I want to talk about. So, whatever. It was like this. I know all about Wii games. No one on the internet gives a shit about them.
I am the Weaver.
Wow, way to shit on his memory, bro. Okay, so onward to your quote-unquote commentary about the Wii.
And people talk about, oh, Nintendo is gonna go the way of Sega. Like it's some huge catastrophe. Why? Because Sega's not in the console business anymore? Last time I checked, they were still putting out their shitty Sonic games on every other console. So every generation is the same fucking shit. Like, you would think, I'm not saying graphics can't get any better, that would be naive, graphics will always get better. But is that such a huge problem? Like, can you not appreciate the history? Like, are you that fucking impressed by shiny things sparkling in front of your eyes? I don't want to say it. Are you that fucking stupid? I hope you're not, if you're listening to this.
Oh, I wouldn't worry about people listening to your inane rambling by this point of the video. I mean, we're already like 30 minutes in, and you'd be lucky to hold their attention for 5 minutes, if that. 2 minutes tops. So there you have it, guys. That's me on. Another dime a dozen ranter that you can find literally every fucking where on YouTube. Dude, if I were you, I would crawl backwards with tears in my eyes back to Walmart and beg them to give you your job back. Because you're never going to make it as a comedian, commentator, video maker, none of that. Or as a stand-up comedian. I mean, are we kidding here? For that, you have to have some sort of talent or charisma or suck enough dicks to get to where you want to be. And I just don't see that happening for you, bro. Well, you're good at that last one. Now, you're probably wondering, isn't Asa being a little harsh on this guy? I mean, just look at these next couple of clips real quick.
But I guess that's me. I'm an average all-around gamer. You know, who also lives in the real world. Okay, this show's about the Wii. Suck my balls. I'm sure there's people who think, oh, why would you do a show about the Wii? That's not relevant anymore. Like they know what is relevant and what isn't. You know, like, not current enough for you? Get the fuck out. Americans crack me up, man. You got no educational system, no gay marriage, no healthcare, no gun control. Yeah, I said it. Your economy's in the shitter, and people are racist against the black president. But when it comes to the Wii's graphics, ooh, I dare say, I do declare, these are below my standards, and I'd say we are entitled to much higher than this. This is, my standards are much higher. Fuck you. Fuck your bourgeois, entitled, first world problems bullshit, okay? Well, why do I do these videos in English, you may ask? Well, because English is the easiest language ever. It's the easiest fucking language to learn and to speak and to communicate with. I'm like the Merovingian.
I have sampled every language.
And English is the easiest.
Yeah, you see that misguided anger, that just visceral shit, fuck, shit, ranty rant. That is literally everywhere on YouTube. This guy's nothing new under the sun. And the way he carries himself with this sort of unspoken arrogance, you know, underlying his sentences there, like, you know, I speak the word of God and I'm this great, you know, comedian guy. You're not, dude. Just drop the act and just be yourself. And I'm not getting that vibe from this guy. And clearly his numbers, you know, show that this is not what YouTube wants either. So, food for thought. Yeah. Till next time, dear viewer, I'm gonna go watch something good now.
That's the thing. I don't want to do a show. I watch a lot of these shows. I'm not saying there shouldn't be a show or many shows that inform the consumer. I'm just saying that's not the kind of show I want to do. I can't think of anything more boring for myself than to be here every week.
And that is why you should quit, Mion. Remember, down the road, not across the street. P.S. America rules, bitch.